All right, Microsoft just built an AI scientist that works 12 hours straight and actually makes real discoveries, while at the same time announcing plans for a humanist superintelligence designed to serve humanity. Google dropped an autonomous data scientist that writes, tests, and fixes its own Python code. And China's Moonshot AI unveiled a new open-source reasoning model that can think across hundreds of steps. All of this happened within just a few days, so let's talk about it. Let's start with the one that shocked the research world, KOSMOS. It's backed by Microsoft researchers, and it's basically the first real AI scientist that actually does science from start to finish. You give it a goal in a data set, say brain scans, genetics data, or some complex material science problem, and it locks in for 12 straight hours. During that time, it reads over 1,500 research papers, writes around 40,000 lines of Python code, runs analysis, tests hypotheses, and then generates a full research report, complete with citations and executable code. No humans guiding it midway, just pure autonomous scientific work. In early trials, KOSMOS actually made new discoveries across biology, neuroscience, and clean energy materials. One of its experiments uncovered how cooling protects the brain. When temperature drops, brain cells switch into an energy-saving mode, recycling molecules instead of creating new ones. Another project revealed that humidity beyond a certain threshold destroys perovskite solar cells during production, a real-world factor that later got confirmed by human researchers. KOSMOS even found a shared mathematical rule for how neurons connect across species, humans, mice, flies, showing that all brains might follow the same wiring pattern. And the discoveries just kept coming. It pinpointed a heart-protecting protein called SOD2, showing how it prevents scarring, then traced a DNA variant that helps people resist diabetes by regulating a stress responder gene in insulin cells. It even mapped out the exact moment brain cells begin collapsing in Alzheimer's and explained why some neurons age faster than others, linking it to lost flipase genes that trigger the brain's immune system to destroy them. Now, what makes KOSMOS so capable is the way it's structured. It runs hundreds of smaller AI agents, each handling a part of the process. Some read and summarize papers, others analyze data, others write code. They all share a single internal memory called a world model. That world model keeps track of everything, what's already done, what worked, and what needs testing next. It's like a brain made of subbrains planning long investigations without losing context. When independent scientists reviewed KOSMOS reports, they found that nearly 80% of its scientific statements were accurate, an insane rate for something running completely on its own. One 12-hour session of KOSMOS produced about the same amount of work as 6 months of human research time. The reports looked like early-stage academic papers, complete with graphs, statistics, and references. Reviewers said it felt like reading the work of a junior researcher, except this one can run hundreds of experiments overnight and never get tired. Of course, it still needs humans in the loop. The best results came from a scientist-in-the-loop setup. Humans define the goal and data, KOSMOS does the deep grind, and humans check what's worth pursuing. It struggles with messy or unlabeled datasets, and it can't yet handle raw images or files larger than about 5 GB. It also can't take mid-experiment instructions. Once it starts a 12-hour run, it goes all in. But the bigger limitation isn't computing power, it's judgment. Teaching KOSMOS how to recognize which ideas are meaningful, not just statistically correct. Still, this marks a turning point. AI is conducting real research with measurable outcomes. Now, while KOSMOS is busy discovering new biology, Microsoft itself is thinking even bigger. Mustafa Suleyman just announced something called Humanist Superintelligence, and it's not about beating humans, but about serving them. According to him, this AI will be designed only to serve humanity, keeping people at the top of the food chain. The plan is to build a kind of super intelligent system that's bounded, not an open-ended entity with total autonomy, but a carefully controlled intelligence with human values baked in. Suleyman wrote that Microsoft wants to reject the whole race to AGI narrative, even though legally, Microsoft can now develop AGI independently of OpenAI. That's thanks to a new deal letting them use OpenAI's IP for their own AGI projects, which means the rivalry between the two is about to explode. Suleyman's vision is a bit different, though. He describes this humanist superintelligence as a companion that helps people learn, act, and stay productive, kind of like a deeply integrated assistant that supports you emotionally and cognitively. The same system could assist in healthcare and drive scientific discovery in areas like clean energy. He keeps emphasizing that at Microsoft AI, humans matter more than AI. Their superintelligence is meant to stay controllable, contextual, and subordinate, the opposite of a runaway system. It's a direct contrast to the open-ended ambition we've seen from OpenAI and Anthropic. And speaking of Anthropic, there's new competition coming straight out of China. Moonshot AI just released Kimi K2 Thinking, and it's openly challenging the reasoning models from both OpenAI and Anthropic. The company calls it their best open source thinking model, and what makes it interesting is that it doesn't just generate text, it thinks step by step, uses external tools, executes code, and reasons across hundreds of sequential steps completely on its own. Technically, it's impressive. K2 Thinking scored 40.9% on Humanity's last exam. That's a benchmark with thousands of expert-level questions spanning over 100 disciplines. On BrowseComp, which tests continuous browsing and research ability, it hit 60.2%, double the human bench line of 29.2. And on SWE Bench Verified, a major coding benchmark, it scored 71.3%. What's even crazier is its ability to execute up to 300 sequential tool calls without human input. That means it can chain hundreds of reasoning steps, reading, planning, searching, coding, verifying, until it reaches a solid conclusion. Moonshot AI showed this off by giving it a PhD-level math problem from hyperbolic geometry. K2 Thinking went through 23 nested reasoning and tool calls, searched papers, executed Python code, verified intermediate results, and derived the correct formula. That's the kind of multi-step planning even top commercial models struggle with. In real use, it can build full websites or word style editors from a single prompt, doing complex front-end work like React components. It can also run research tasks that involve multiple moving parts. One example had it identify an actor, Jimmy Gary Jr., from a vague, multi-clue description involving a university degree, NFL career, and film roles. The model ran more than 20 searches, checked sources like Wikipedia and IMDb, and assembled a coherent answer. This ability for long horizon reasoning, thinking across hundreds of steps, is quickly becoming the next frontier in AI. Moonshot AI is betting on open source as its edge, while US labs keep their reasoning models proprietary. They're also exploring test time scaling, which basically means giving the model more reasoning tokens and time to think. That's the new battlefield, how long and coherently an AI can plan before it loses focus. Then there's Google, and they're taking a completely different approach with something called DS-Star. If KOSMOS is an AI scientist, DS-Star is an AI data scientist, a system that can take messy business data and turn it into working Python code all by itself. Most AI data tools today work with clean SQL databases, but DS-Star was built for chaos. CSVs, JSON logs, markdown files, text reports, random spreadsheets. You ask it a question in plain English like, which products performed best in Q3 based on sales and reviews, and it figures out where that data lives, writes Python code to combine it, tests the results, fixes its own bugs, and returns the answer. No human analyst needed. Underneath, it runs a swarm of 6 specialized agents. One scans and summarizes every file, noting column names, data types, and snippets. Another plans the steps. Another writes the Python code. Then there's a verifier that checks if the code worked, a router that decides what to do if it didn't, and a finalizer that formats the output. This loop can repeat up to 20 times for each task, meaning DS-Star keeps rewriting and testing until the result makes sense. And when the code crashes, missing columns, wrong types, bad joins, an A-debugger module automatically repairs it. It studies the error logs, reanalyzes the files, and patches the script. Meanwhile, a retriever module uses Google's Gemini embedding 001 to rank the most relevant files, so it doesn't waste time on irrelevant data. It only pulls the top 100 files into context, keeping everything efficient. The whole system runs on Gemini 2.5 Pro, Google's most advanced model for reasoning and code generation. On its own, Gemini 2.5 Pro performs well, but paired with DSStar's multi-agent structure, the results skyrocket. On Dabstep, a tough benchmark for data analysis reasoning, Gemini alone scored 12.7% on the hardest tasks. With DSStar, that jumped to 45.24%. On Chroma Bench, which tests file retrieval from huge data lakes, it scored 44.7% compared to 39.8% for the best competing system. On DA Code, it reached 37.1% versus 32% for the next best. That's a massive 30-point leap in real-world data performance. What makes DSStar so important is its independence from perfect data. Most enterprise information is messy, scattered across cloud drives, shared folders, random Excel sheets. DSStar reads and adapts to that chaos like a human analyst, but faster and with its own self-debugging loop. It's also model agnostic, meaning it can plug into Gemini GPT-5 or Claude 4.5. The architecture stays the same. Tests showed the real advantage isn't just the model, but the iterative, self-correcting process itself. We've entered the stage where AI doesn't just assist the process, it is the process. Wild times for AI, right? Let me know what you think down below and subscribe for more deep dives. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.